Well, the golf club has evolved over quite a few number of years, trying to constantly make improvements, but it's really a nice golf club. And of course, being on the bluffs of the Missouri River, as you look down about 75 or 80 feet to the river below, it's a pretty spectacular view.
Lawrence Naminga has been part of the Springfield Golf Club since the beginning. There had been a club in Springfield a century ago, but it was abandoned. In the 80s, those who traveled to the Tyndall area to play wanted a track closer to home.
This group of people decided, you know, let's have a golf course. And so with the fact that the property could be obtained through the Corps of Engineers, through a 99-year lease, and the fact that we still had Company D 153rd Engineer Battalion here in Springfield as a National Guard unit, we utilized those things to build the golf course. And then there was a lot of interest. Not that there isn't that interest now, there is, but we had a lot of volunteer people come out and put in a lot of time raking, planting and doing whatever else it took.
Some of what it took was to leave the trees that were native to the area, utilize the river to build an irrigation system, and to continue to volunteer for maintenance and to run the clubhouse.
Yeah, it's got to be a community project. Just having seven or eight golfers in Springfield that want to have a golf course isn't enough. You've got to have the support from the town. And to be honest with you, you've got to have the support from other communities around you, too.
For instance, for an additional fee, you can be a member at both Springfield and the Bonham course near Tyndall. But you don't have to see the golf course to know that there's an interest in town. You can do that just by driving down Main Street.
Because when we purchased it from Howard, I think the inventory was four cars. That's what we purchased with some parts. And then we did major improvements to the showroom and expanded from there.
That's how Cindy Lutens, her husband, and another couple launched Mr. Golf Car. And to say they've expanded is an understatement. Their trade area extends 120 miles in every direction from Springfield and into several aspects of the golf car business, like a tournament fleet.
A golf course will call and say, we're having a tournament next month. We need 24 cars. Will they be available? And, you know, then we give them prices, and yes, we got them. And so we'll take them there, and they use them for the day or 2 days, whatever the tournament is. And then, we do that all summer long. That's one. We lease cars to golf courses where they lease them for 3 to 5 years, depending on the cars. And those cars stay at the golf course the duration of the lease. And we go in once a year and service them. If the cars happen to cause any trouble, we go down to service them right as soon as we're notified. And then, of course, selling cars is our main part of the business, selling up to individuals and courses.